Welcome to another installment of Bud's Smart Home. Today we're diving into the Heimdall app, a robust security system designed to work seamlessly with your Homey Pro hub. Whether you're looking to enhance your home security or just geek out over some cool tech, this guide will walk you through the setup process and highlight the app's standout features. Heimdall is a versatile security app designed for the Homey Pro hub. It offers real-time monitoring, customizable alerts, and integration with various sensors and devices. With Heimdall, you can transfer your Homey Pro into a comprehensive security system. Let's get the Heimdall app installed on your Homey Pro. Once installed, I'll take you through the entire Heimdall app setup and configuration via the Homey Pro web app. You can also set up Heimdall on the mobile app if you prefer. Okay, to set up the Heimdall app, you want to go to the official Homey Pro store. I'll leave a link in the description below. Type Heimdall in the search bar, hit enter, and you'll see the Heimdall app listed here. So click on that. Click on Install App. Make sure your Homey Pro hub is selected, and then hit Install App. And it indicates that it'll be installed on Homey shortly. So you can close that, switch over to your web application. In the web application, you're going to see I have some favorite devices in here. I'm going to show you how to install these two tiles, which are part of the Heimdall app. These tiles here I added. These are essentially virtual switches. The reason I added them is that in the surveillance tile, if I open that up, you see there's three modes. These are very similar to the modes that you'll see in SmartThings. In SmartThings, the only difference is instead of saying partially armed, it's called armed stay. But it's essentially the same concept. So armed would happen when everyone's away from home, in my instance. Disarmed would be as it sounds. There's going to be no alarm condition if one of the doors or motion sensors are triggered. And then partially armed is a state that you can use while everyone's sleeping at night. So I have our home go into partially armed or armed stay mode during the evening hours. So I wanted to be able to visually see those modes, and so I set up these tiles. So if I click on armed stay, you're going to see it go to partially armed in their surveillance tile. So we'll click on armed stay. I'll turn that state on. Now if I go back to the surveillance tile, you see it's now in partially armed. Or within the Heimdall app, I can change surveillance to disarmed, and you'll see on the tiles that changes the visual to disarm. I did install the app. If you want to verify that the app was installed, you go to the settings cog here in the bottom lower left-hand side, and then you look under integrations. You should see the Heimdall app there in the list of integrations. So if we click on that, you're going to see there's a configure button, which we'll go into in just a moment. Before we get started, just make sure that the app is enabled and that it's set for automatic updates. So once you have verified that, go ahead and hit configure. In here, we're going to kind of work from the right to left. We're going to click on this first tab. Here is some of the information that I'm going to cover today, basically listed here, showing you how to configure Heimdall. So if there's something that I missed or you don't quite understand, you can review these instructions to make sure that everything is set up. But it's going to tell you in here the first step is to create that surveillance mode switch. And you're basically going to add a device, and then you're going to add it from within the Heimdall app. So I'm going to show you how to do that. Also later on here, you're going to add an alarm off button, and that's to be used in the flow to disable the alarm. So we'll just go ahead and create both of those switches within the Heimdall app. So I'm going to close out of here for now. We're going to hit the plus blue up here to add a device. We're going to say new device, find the Heimdall app, click on it. And here's the two switches that I've created in here. So to create them, you're basically going to hit mode. You're going to hit connect. And then in my case, it says no devices found because I've already created this. New device, Heimdall. Do the same thing with alarm, hit connect. And when you're done, you should have these two tiles up here. So again, the surveillance tile gives you the three alarm states, which can be used within routines. and the alarm shows you that all is quiet. But if an alarm is triggered, that'll change it to an alarm state that can be used within routines to trigger actions. All right, so that's the switches that I'm using. I'm also using the dome siren as part of this. So let's go back into settings and find Heimdall and go back into configure. And we'll work through these tabs. Now the first tab going right to left is settings. And I think most of these I left at the default settings. I have arming delay. So this is how soon do you want your surveillance system to be triggered once you indicate that you, maybe you left home or you've manually hit a pin to activate the alarm. I have it set for 5 seconds. So I wanted it to arm quickly. But if you wanted time to get out of a home, say for instance you're using your garage door as one of the sensors that could be triggered, then you would want maybe 3 to 5 minutes delay, so that you have time to get out of the house before the surveillance mode is triggered. For my purposes, I left this at 5 seconds. The alarm delay is once a sensor is triggered, so your surveillance system is active and someone opened the door, how soon do you want the alarm to sound? Now, the reason you may want to delay here is if you have to come inside the home and you have a keypad, you want to physically disarm the system, you may want to give yourself a couple minutes to do that, so the alarm will not trigger for at least 2 minutes in that scenario, so that you have time to deactivate the system. I have these delays working during the arm mode and also in the partially arm mode, so in either case, both of these things apply. I did not select allow alarm while in alarm delay. Logging, I'll show you the log in just a moment, but I only wanted log items when the mode is active. In other words, surveillance is active. I wanted to know what events occurred while surveillance was active. Rest of these I left off. I'm not going to go into every one of them, but these, when do you want it to write to the log? I selected when the surveillance mode is changed, when it's the alarm is activated or deactivated, and also when a contact device hasn't communicated. So that could be in a situation where you have a battery that is no longer good. This will let you know when surveillance mode is pulling the device, it can't reach it because it's either offline or the battery's dead, something like that. So that's the settings screen. Let's go to the next one, which is users. I have not enabled anything here, but you can add users. So give permissions to someone to be able to enable the alarm or disable the alarm. As a default, you will always be the administrator and that portion of it can't be disabled or deleted. So if you wanted to add someone else to have that ability, you could do that in here. The devices shows you all devices that would be used by Heimdall that you can configure. So these would be essentially, again, all motion sensors as well as contact sensors on your doors. Let's look at the settings screen. This is where you select the devices that you want to use or you want Heimdall to monitor, I should say, and to what extent you want it to monitor. So I have selected monitoring of basically exterior doors. So I have a living room exterior door, a garage man door, and also a kitchen door. And I want it monitored while the home is fully armed and also while it's partially armed. So fully armed, an example would be when everyone leaves home, our house automatically goes into full surveillance state. And at evening, while we're asleep, it's in partially armed state. So if any of these doors would open during either surveillance mode, the alarm would be triggered. I did not select any motion sensors, but in your setup, you may want to select other doors or other motion sensors as well. And so we just reviewed devices. In the dashboard, this is the log that I referred to earlier. So this is a timeline of all of the actions that are being performed by Heimdall, and you see there's a long history here. So it gives the events that occurred by date and time. So when I was showing you or demonstrating going from partially armed to disarmed, you see those events indicated in here. And surveillance mode is disarmed. Surveillance mode is partially disarmed, so it shows you what happened and when it happened. And that's essentially it. So once you have the devices going to be used set up and also these delays and triggers set up in the settings screen, then what you'll do next is write your flows. Now, I did a previous video that shows the flow that I'm going to show you now. But on my security, I have essentially two flows. The main flow is the surveillance flow. This is what tells Heimdall what to do. And then I have a blinking light flow that essentially is a subroutine of this flow that causes some of my lights in my house to blink red whenever there's an alarm triggered. So let's go into the main flow here. I'm going to collapse this screen here so it'll give you a little more viewing area. And just generally talk about this because I go into a lot more explanation of what these flows do in the prior video. So I'll leave a link so that you can check that out if you want to get into this in a little more detail. But essentially I have four separate kind of flows in here. And within this flow, which is alarms and notifications, this is where the blinking light flow is triggered. So you can have subroutines like that. You can have certain flows trigger other flows, which is pretty neat. So the first section is mode status changes. The only purpose of this section is to essentially, if I tap one of those virtual switches, change it from disarmed to partially armed, it reflects that change in that surveillance switch that we set up in Heimdall. And vice versa, if I change a surveillance mode within the surveillance switch in Heimdall, then that status will be reflected in these virtual switches. Then the next section is time-based mode changes. So this, if you're familiar with SmartThings, these are essentially the good night routine that changes the system from disarmed to partially armed during the night hours so that we have protection at night. And the good morning flow basically turns the system from partially armed back to disarmed. So that's all there is to that. The presence mode changes is important because what this mode does is when everyone leaves home, then the surveillance system is set to arm. And again, when this happens, it also changes those virtual switches, which also changes SmartThings modes. And then when any one person comes back to our home, the home is automatically disarmed. The last section here is alarms and notifications. So if the surveillance system is in an armed state and any of those exterior doors are open that I showed you earlier, the alarm would be activated and that would set off a number of events, which include notices on my Echo devices, the turning on of my dome alarm, the push notifications sent to each family member, and that blinking light flow that I talked about earlier. There would be an announcement made on the Echo Show, which is in our kitchen, notifying the intruder that authorities would be dispatched to home. And there would also be notifications sent to both of our mobile devices, giving us an option to check out the situation with the cameras and making sure whether or not there is an actual alarm state. And then we could have the option to disable the alarm right from our phones. If we disable the alarms, then a number of actions are carried out, including changing the surveillance mode back to disarm, deactivating the alarm state in Heimdall, stop the blinking light flow, turn off the dome siren, and basically turn off some of the lights that may have turned on as a result of the alarm state. There is another section here that's optional, and I have another number of announcements that go on to the Echo devices in our home and also some push notifications that go out as well. So that's essentially the flow. That's probably more complex than it needs to be because in most situations, most people are going to use this triggering the system as active whenever everyone leaves and then disarming the system when anyone comes home. That's the main purpose of the surveillance system. And then a lot of these other flows are basically optional. So hopefully that gives you an idea of how to set up Heimdall. I didn't take a deep dive in it. There's a lot more information available on the Homey forum if you want to check that out. With its customizable features and seamless integration, Heimdall offers a robust security solution that's easy to manage. Go ahead and give it a try. Feel free to reach out if you have any questions or need further assistance. Just use the comments below. Happy automating, and thank you for selecting Bud's Smart Home, where we bring you the best in smart home technology.